bid was put in place, each business within the business improvement district has to pay 1.5% of your business rates. That is collected in the normal way by the council. The bid paid the council for the privilege, and that money is then disseminated out to the World Chamber of Commerce, who manage that money. Off the top of my head, I think it's something like about 400,000, there or thereabouts, give a couple of shilling. That money is then split into those four categories to sort of support those things. So whilst it seems in a big lot of money, it is a lot of money, but when you sort of spread it over the area of the bid, the area of the bid actually goes from, if you go from 12 Keys College up Watson Street, Exmouth Street, up to Oxton Road, Grange Road West, over to the YMCA where Nigel is, and then back along Borough Road into town. It takes in everything on the left hand side, which is all the retail area, Argyle Street, everything to the right as well, so the contact centre, down as far as the Town Hall, back onto Woodside, and then Woodside then back to the 12 Keys, so it's a massive, massive area. So if you sort of dissect that money up, how quickly it disappears, it soon goes. Soon goes.
Chairman, please. You talk about Swan and town, and you look, the routes going in towards town, whether it be Hobbit or whatever. That's the first impression people get. People go there and stuff like this.
It is, and I agree with what you're saying, but it comes back to.
Come out the bridges, come out the 53, come out the Wallace, it's up, they come this way, and then you see.
No, I take your point. I mean, it goes back to what I've just said there with regards to the money. I mean, I'm probably not going to be shouted out for saying this, but we got a bill for sort of planters, and you're looking at sort of 8, 9 grand, 10 grand. Well, you know, you start, and that's only for a few in the town centre. So by the time you start, you know, moving out, and I would love to have it out of Poy Lake Road, I would love to have it at the other end of Borough Road. You know, by Trammy Rovers, who've just been promoted. So, you know, that's what it should be, but there's not the money to do it. So we've got to be realistic, we've got to sort of manage people's expectations. I would love to say, and come along with the magic wand and say, look, you know, everything's brilliant. It's going to take time. Things like that might come in the future, but I agree, yeah, that their points of reference, their points of areas that we should sort of try and do. But the bid is a geographical area, and we've got to work with them, Matthew.
George?
Yeah, Mark, just sort of point that I heard you say you're going to do some work on a volunteer strategy, but I do know World Council actually did one, I think it was Nancy Kitts, was it? Did a World Strategy, spent a lot of time on that. Also, what I'd say is that the big local commission for Community Council World to do some work on volunteer borders, so that might be useful. I think you've got an ideal opportunity where I think the word volunteer puts people off. So maybe Birkenhead Ambassador would be a better way of dealing with it. And also, to sort of pitch for us, if you get some volunteers, we've got some qualifications they can have if you come to see us. Horticulture is one of them.
Well, that might be something that we'll take it up on. I mean, certainly, and I really appreciate that, George. We've never slowed down before. I mean, things like that are very important. I mean, what I've found is, and since coming out of the police organisation, there's lots and lots of brilliant organisations doing lots and lots of brilliant work. But unfortunately, there's lots of those doing it into little silos. Yeah. You know, how you get past that, I don't know. Everybody, you know, if we were producing electricity, we'd be able to light up the town centre for the next 100,000 years on all our sorts of enthusiasm for it all. But, you know, there needs to be this cross-border talk, and there needs to be this overarching sort of thing. I know it's probably creating more sort of committees, etc., etc., but there needs to be that. We're all after the same thing, ultimately, at the end of the day. All you sat around here, you're all representing your wards, you're all trying to do the right thing. But it's just one of those things, as a mere sort of mortal, I'm not a political person, I just say it how it is. As I say, I've been in the cops for 30 years, so I've seen most things, and certainly most things in the town centre. So it is about trying to bring people together. Partly the bid, try and do that, as I say, within the business community. But our remit goes into all sorts of communities, not just the business, because it affects everybody. Affects everybody, you know.
Ask one, please, Ange.
Yeah, no, I just wanted to say, really, I think those kind of connections are okay, aren't they, really? And to pick up on your point about kind of joining up different parts of the borough. So I know that one of our kind of local residence groups in Pranton, the Pranton Ridge Community Group, Matt, I think it was here, they met Nigel from the YMCA, and that was one of the things they spoke about joining, you know, joining things up and the blue and stuff, which, you know, Joe, you're very involved in as well. So, you know, I think those connections are absolutely
vital. I mean, things like Woodside, I mean, we had a quote for some brickwork, and it was astronomical. But if we can get sort of community-spirited individuals who have got skills, one, they take ownership of the project. You know, why not just put a big plaque up saying this was done through this group or this organisation? Make people proud, so that when they go down there, they say, I did that. And they sell their kids, and their kids sell their kids. That's what it's all about, isn't it? It's about moving forward, it's about doing things right.
Okay, I want to move on, if you don't mind, to continue.
The brickwork, you say, use the colleges for the apprenticeships?
Yeah, we do, we are doing.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Yeah. Mark, can I thank you for your presentation? It's very enlightening, it's a great idea, a fabulous idea, in fact. And you quoted the night on the Sunday after the bank holiday. And the crowd set out in the hundreds.
4,000.
And absolutely superb evening. And I think the people of Bethead will respond if you give them something to respond to. And the word you used before, to me, is the absolute word, pride. Let's get pride back into it.
I mean, I want to just take this opportunity, and I know you're all councillors within your own specific ward, but the bid needs your support. It's as simple as that. Shout about us. Tell everybody. Tell your constituents. Tell everybody. You'll get re-voted. Tell them.
Thank you very much. Before we move on, I mean, Mr. Pallias is sitting down there at the back, and he's been asked tonight to bring one of the cups. So, Mark, would you like to just give us 2 minutes, I mean 2 minutes of your time, show us the trophy, if you can, please, Mark, do it now. Please.
No, we can.
First of all, thank you to George for inviting me here. We're talking about tonight, you know, I didn't expect to speak, I've just started bringing the cup down. And walking down through the estate. But it was a great opportunity to speak to the Liverpool and Everton fans and say, you recognise these things. But let us have our day in the sun. It's been 27 years apparently since we won anything. So I think some of the things you've been saying here, and I was listening with interest, it's similar to what we've been trying to do with the club. And that's, for me, I have a great belief that you know, you should hold yourselves, and that's what the community centre is about. And people look at and think we've had any success as a club, and I was sitting there in the 70th minute here at Wembley, and I was actually the calmest person in the place when we were going on. People don't believe me. For those of you who don't know, we were down to 10 men in the first minute, and so forth and so on. And it was one all at the time, and I looked at it and thought, you know what, they're not going to score. That's the opposition. They didn't know how to break us down. And this is either going to go to penalties or we're going to win. But there was other things that were coming together at the same time. One was I hadn't sacked the manager when they told me to sack him. And part of that is because tactically he's very, very good. And actually you saw on the day he changed the tactics. For those who don't want to be bored by football, he made the changes that were right ones. So I felt vindicated in that. The team itself have been together, so again there's a oneness in the team because of our policy of trying to keep the squad rather than turn it over the season. And the final thing is relevant to what you're talking about today, about the 60th minute, we were flagging a little bit because playing with 10 men is quite difficult, and playing with Wembley with 10 men is really difficult. And then the fans came in, and that to me was a fantastic coming together of everybody around the club, which we've been building for years. The 3 or 4 years since we've been here, we've been building that. But it's the same principle you've all been talking about, and that's self-help. And rather than sit and moan and whinge about a player misconsoling the ball, they actually came out, and they all got together, and they all pulled it out of the line. And so I've had so many people come to me and say that, you know, there were grown men crying I wasn't really amongst them, I was on the edge of it. But what's also quite interesting, lots of people standing next to their partners and wives said to me, that was the best day of my life. So surely I can't be responsible for a lot of... The point is that by working together, it's tremendously powerful. And there's a spirit around the club at this point in time that it comes from everybody. They've got it. They've finally got the piece. And part of that comes from the work we were doing in the community. And people were coming up to me over the last few years and said, you know, I'm proud of my club again. When we went to work on the Tuesday morning, the best thing for me was they went to proud of my club again. And it's that pride that you get from, it's an esoteric concept of football club, for those of you who don't understand it. But it is, and somehow it galvanises people and focuses them on that they can help themselves and they do it for themselves. The community stuff that, George, we're invited here. I think you hit your light on for a bushel. I think you also contributed to our Super White Christmas.
Yeah.
Which is something that we do around the club whereby we get the homeless in on Christmas Day, and we get the lonely on Christmas Day, we get the homeless in on Boxing Day. And for the kids, we actually, we collect, using the club as a prison, the goodwill that surrounds the club, and on the back of that comes all the food, comes all that we give to the food banks, that comes all the toys that we give to the kids at Christmas, and you guys contribute to quite a bit of food and to the stuff that we have. So that's the way that the club's being used. Once again, it's drawing out of the community spirit, and it wasn't just words when we came and we said that. So that piece of silverware, to some extent, is to me a vindication of that as the tactic, the strategy that we use. Beach, we're here, we came to see you, just if this is an opportunity to, but we came to see you, I think, with the council, only 2 years ago.
Yeah.
And we talked about the community centre over there, and to my chagrin, nothing's been done at this point in time. I know the community centre has been, the sports centre, sorry, has been refurbed, but what we would like to do is to bring to this community, because part of the vision is to have Tranmere Road is located physically in its community, delivering the stuff that we deliver at the rec centre at Prenton Park. How powerful is that? It's using the club as a magnet to bring in people who wouldn't go to more conventional organisations. So we've successfully gone to college, and George, you know, we've got a lot of programmes through, and I wasn't asked to come in to say this, by the way, this isn't the pitch, but I'm just saying that that's something that we think we could do here. There's nothing stronger than me. The lads off the estate are coming here. They're doing educational stuff, and it doesn't conflict with the stuff that we do, because we've sorted that out, the ground rules on that, as it were. And I just think that we'd be able to contribute something here. And for us, that's great, because we suddenly create Tranmere Rovers supporters sitting here on the estate. Well, thank you for the time.
Thank you. Georgie, would you like to give us your report, please?
Just a few words.
Again, 2 minutes.
Okay, yeah, I will literally be 2 minutes. I'm Georgie Minery, I'm the neighbourhood community inspector. I don't think we can get away from the fact that it's quite a challenging landscape, policing-wise, but in the spirit of what's been said before, let me say the page not, of what's been said before, collaboratively and working together, I think we're a lot stronger and we work really well together. And just an example of that today, and that's what I'm going to speak about, we ran a day of action near Well Lane on Morton Road, which is in Rockferry, if you don't know. And as I say, working together with all our partners, really heavily connected with the Man Social Behaviour team, obviously the councillors, with Joe, the constituency manager. We ran a day of action which involves enforcement on our behalf, so that's we executed 4 warrants on Oriel Road, and then we followed that up with a lot of engagement with the community in that street. So we had the councillors in the street, we had Joe, we had probation cleaning up the alleyways, and we had skips provided by the council in the street so people could empty out and tidy up their houses and tidy up the community. And that is about partners all working together the residents taking some ownership for themselves and tidying up their streets. As a result from the community today, well, as a result of our warrant and our enforcement activity, three people were arrested, we recovered numerous drugs, some really nasty knives, some, I say nasty knives, all knives are nasty, but some significant weapons were recovered. And we got some community intelligence and information enough to close one of the properties. So using civil law and social behaviour act, we can gather enough information, intelligence from the community to actually close a house, which means that within 28 days, residents from a house that's been causing significant antisocial behaviour on that street, they will have to leave that address. And that's massive for that street because, as you know, antisocial behaviour is a huge problem that we have. But a lot of the time it's perpetrated by certain individuals, so we can get rid of those individuals. It sends a really strong message out to the community. All of that work is the police working with our partners. And I say, I think that just echoes what's been said before, or certainly by yourself, Mark and Gemma, working together, we're a lot stronger than working individually. Really difficult climate for the police at the moment, as it is for all of our partners, but working together and with the communities, I think we've shown some really positive results.
It was a really successful day. It's been a problem for us for quite a while. We are delighted with the outcome from today. We were there to see how it worked with all the different partners involved. But the police were fantastic today, as were the community payback team and the antisocial behaviour team. We're really, really grateful that something actually positive, really positive, came up today.
Well, I think what got me was the rubbish that people put out. It's just, it was awful. Some of the stuff that those people had to collect today was horrible. The entries were an awful mess. But there were some nice pyjamas, there were loads of people in pyjamas. But no, thank you. It was really, really good. Very, very positive. Thank you.
I would like to ask,
do you find this hard, picking up youngsters with these off-road buttons?
Bikes come up all the time, only the motorbikes, the off-road bikes.
On the skateboard
thing. I know you do. And it is, sorry, it is a difficult and challenging environment for us in terms of bikes. And we do a lot of work to try and get the bikes off the streets. There's been obviously a lot of press about it as well. So yes, we do struggle. We have just been given a little bit more security from police officers in terms of chasing bikes. In terms of legislation by the government, it's very difficult to pursue these bikes.
So what do you do with them when you do catch
bikes? So when we catch them, obviously most of them are either stolen. Looking generally badly, they're being a lot of them are stolen, or they are not registered. So we deal with people criminally through that, obviously, and we deal with them in a stronger way as we can. As I say, they're arrested, their bikes have taken off them, and we should try and remove as many of these bikes as possible. We did have a spate of bikes being stolen, that has very much sort of calmed down. These bikes are left burnt out, and we recover those. We've had a lot of work with the Merseyside Fire Rescue just to recover those bikes. But we do take it very seriously, and we do penalise those individuals as strongly as we can, whether that be just as driving with no licence, no insurance, theft of the bikes, that kind of thing. We do try and punish them because we know it's another significant cause of antisocial behaviour.
Okay, thank you, Georgia. Thank you very much indeed. So, item 8 is for noted, okay?
Great,
and report. Item 9 is. Any questions? We've got no questions.
No questions.
Sorry. No problem. So, with that, can I thank you for coming along this evening? Thank you for two excellent presentations. It's been very, very, very good indeed. I really enjoyed it. And I think the message for tonight is let's all work together.
Yeah.
So, thank you so much indeed. George.
Admittedly, what I didn't say, a big thank you to World Council on behalf of the Little Centre. We've been fortunate through Joe and through Sheila Henry, I've had Sheila Henry working with me or 2 days a week here, my PA, and we could not be where we are now. Be where we are now. We've got the new manager, and she gives us the support, so a big thank you.
Absolutely. Can I also thank Sheila, Linda and Steve Carney for putting the food on for us tonight.
Oh, yeah.
I think that's an excellent thing, so thank you very much indeed. I declare the meeting closed. Thank you very much indeed.